There's an update of my 125-gallon display tank upstairs. Got the Red Hot Strawberry Dragon Blood. Got the OB Raspberry. He helped me breed a lot of offsprings from him. I've since retired him. Also, the Strawberry Dragon Blood, he's infertile now, so I've retired him. There's a Ruby Red Dragon Blood F1. Is the Dragon Blood variety OB. There's his brother over there. Here's your Sunshine Peacock. It's full of yellow goodness. Here's my breeder albino strawberry. Yeah, he knows I'm talking about him. And there's another regular strawberry dragon blood. He's a tank boss. It's looking good. This tank needs a water change. It's way overdue after a couple of months. Let me show you how my FX6 is running. Nice and quiet. I've installed that ceiling light over there. Maintenance was last done September 15, 2022. So this has been running problem free for over a year. Let's take a look at the other chamber. Get the same exact FX6. The only difference is that I got a lot of my power connections over there with the Wi-Fi switch, so I can easily switch the pumps and the lights on and off on my phone. And I've added the sound dampener panels. Because my master bedroom is directly above the ceiling there. So when it's all quiet at night, I could hear the slight humming noise being transmitted through the wall. I mean, these walls don't have a lot of insulation. It's very thin, so. That's the reason why I installed those noise dampening panels. They help a little bit. They don't eliminate the noise 100%. But it helps some. It's better than not having them. So, as you can see, my water level is kind of low. So, probably be doing a water change in the next couple days. So they're doing good. I hardly ever have any fish deaths in this tank. Hardly ever have to do anything other than just water change every couple months or so. I'd like to point out that I have this pre-filter foam in the filter intake over there. That helps travel out a larger degrees. helps you lengthen the amount of maintenance time. The wave maker go over there, drop to the bottom, so I need to pick that up. And there's another, my filter intake, as you can see, I also put the pre-filter foam on there. And matter of fact, the pipe that's inserted inside the filter foam, I've went ahead and I drilled a bunch of holes in it so you don't get a lot of suction all just at the end of the intake tubing. I find that it creates too much suction there, and then all the debris gets trapped in one location, and it's not very efficient in utilizing all of the real estate on the filter foam. So by drilling a bunch of holes up and down the tubing, it helps spread out the incoming water pressure so that all the debris can get spread out more, and the pre-filter will be working more efficiently. So that's all I got for today. This is a long overdue display tank update. Thank you very much for watching. Like and subscribe, comment if you have any questions, please put it below. And I shall see you in a future video. Take care.